This is the spot! We can cut the half-goofa loose here!
It flies? Of course it flies! It's a half-goofa!
Sounds much happier now! And hey, the storm's gone.
Aye. Perhaps we'll finally earn some goodwill from our Dark Elf friends after all.
Look, Father, thanks for bringing us out here, but you don't have to do this kind of stuff just to keep my mind off Ragnar, you know?
This was not a distraction.
No? Then why are we really out here?
Have you ever considered? He just wants to spend time with you, lad, while he still can.
Really?
We do not know what lies ahead, but if Ragnarok approaches, I wish to enjoy the time we have left.
I don't know what to say. Thank you for bringing us out here. I'm glad we did this.
As am I.
There's something I'm not sure I quite understand. In the Ragnarok prophecy, Odin knows, all the realms get destroyed, including Asgard. When the Virgin Gorilla kept secret, Asgard still falls. Wouldn't Odin have tried to prevent it either way? What difference did her lie really make?
Enough. We will continue later.
Father, can we build a lyre together?
The instrument. Why?
We hunt, train. Those are the only two things you do to distract yourself.
They are not distractions.
Oh, of course not.
I just thought it'd be nice to learn some music. You could teach me, and... No. It's stupid. Never mind.
I've been considering your question about whether Groa's deception made a difference. I think of it this way. When it comes to subverting prophecy, knowledge is power. Without the full picture and context, the finer details can lead you to tragically incorrect interpretations. Back in my homeland, I was privy to the operations of a certain coven of Heathwitches who were keen on destabilizing the government. They picked an influential Thane, an otherwise loyal man, and fed him a story of his own ascension to king.
Hold. We will finish later.
Huh?
I wanted to ask you something about your blade. The ones from your homeland.
What of them?
Why don't you just throw them away? I see the way you look at them sometimes. Like you're... I don't know. Like you hate them.
Even hateful things have their uses. Besides, I tried. They came back.
Returning to my anecdote about the Heath Witches, they fed the Thane a prophecy of his ascension to king. They dressed it up in enough details they knew would come to pass, so when they did, the Thane took it as confirmation. Next thing you know, he's helping matters along. He murders his king, sleeping under his own roof. Murders many he once called friends, too, thinking them fated to oppose him. Then, for a finishing touch, the witches revisit this usurper. With just a few details structured ever so misleadingly, they convinced the fool he was invulnerable to all threats.
Physical or magical?
Aye. But 'twas not so for him. All turned into a rather magnificent bloodbath as they go. The Thane ends up without his head and a name so cursed, none dare speak it. All thanks to a subtly deceptive prophecy.
You really gotta write these stories down one day, Mimir.
Well, I try. Jaw tends to get sore, but thank you, lad.
Father, I knew I looked like you.
In what way?
Like, bigger. How do I get muscles like yours?
When you work for them.
But Baldur was really strong. He didn't have any muscles.
My strength does not come from my body. But both are honed by discipline.
What's that mean? It
means you've got the strength of a god no matter what, lad. But if you want to think of one, you'd better start picking heavy things up and putting them back down.
A lot of the sand is cleared up, but there's another storm out that way. You think that means...
Another Hafgufa!
The chisel will not open this.
Did the lighthouse put this lock here? How would they care what happens in the Barrens?
A fair question. But until we find the right key, that poor half-goofer will have to continue its solo act.
Why do you yawn?
Force of habit, I suppose.
Hold that thought. I think it's about to get violent. Falcon on the left! You're on fire, Kratos! It will pass! Tales of a cruel empress, one too angry to die.
We will see.
Did I ever tell the two of you how I made a small fortune in Asgard? Balder arranged for every archer in the city to open fire on him. We took bets on how many arrows could be lodged in his body until the sheer weight of them made him fall down. Ha!
That's awful.
Oh, no, no. He was laughing the whole time. And mine was the closest guess. 446 arrows exactly.
That's horrible. You better not tell that story in front of Freya.
Yes, lad. Because I've suddenly taken leave of my senses.
Just saying.
Brother, in my travels, I heard of a great battle in your homeland at a place called the Gates of Fire.
The Hard Gates.
You were there?
No.
Is that regretting you?
I did regret not dying there for many years, but no longer.
A harp. I can play beautifully, you know.
I do not. I would prefer it remain that way.
Lovely crystal work and those elven gifts you found. I'll be happy to pay you for them.
Surprised to see you out here, Sindri. You must hate the sand.
Oh, it is the worst. But with Brock banned from Alfheim, it's up to me to keep you ship-shape and sharp.
So why is Brock banned from Alfheim?
Oh, that's, I don't know if... Well, do you know what a juicy gnocchi is?
No.
Well, thanks to Brock, the elves sure do.
What is a juicy...
No.
And in pristine condition, too.
Yeah.